Hey guys, this is my first Grandmaster level cast here for anyone on YouTube. You saw me act like a total dork when I promoted. I was really happy that day. Still kind of in disbelief after how long it's taken to finally get into Grandmaster. That was such a cool feeling. So today I was hoping to go ahead and do some ZVT. I've had some really good success with moving into ZVT. Swarm host play really kind of just eliminated anything other than that because I really want to see what I'm capable of as far as pushing that. But this game needed to be cast. This is probably the most intense game I've ever had of StarCraft. It was down to the wire to the very end, and I'm not going to spoil this one, but it was so much fun. It was kind of one of those games where win or lose, we both just played to the best we possibly could, especially towards the end. It was just fighting tooth and nail. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the two-speed treatment here, just because the early game of ZVP is just so not interesting. So here's the introductions. We got me as the Zerg in the upper right, and then we've got Si Yong, Grandmaster player, on the lower left. Getting to the MMR now, where I'm hitting on pretty much exclusively Grandmasters, so really excited about that. I would say maybe 20 to 30% of my games are High Master players, but otherwise it's all Grandmaster, so that's really fun. Alright, we've got that 11 overpool, got a second extractor trick, get out that Zerglings. I find it's actually better to go up to 16 drones and hit a second extractor trick rather than 15 drones. Especially because there's going to be such a long period of time here that I'm not making any drones due to dropping this hatchery. Then I finally make one drone. Actually, normally I make one drone. That time I made two. Normally I make one drone so I can make a consecutive queen. That was a whoops. That's a slight change I'm making to my build. I used to make two drones consecutively, and then my second queen was heavily delayed. But if you just make one drone, you can make the queen almost exactly when the first one pops. From Si Yong, we've got a pretty standard opening so far. Got cannon, gateway, forge, two gas. Nothing too terribly exciting. One thing I was thinking about, actually, I've been kind of contemplating what changed in, you know, my play. Obviously, Swarm Host is a big part of it. I finally have a unit I'm really happy with. But, you know, what's kind of changed for me? And I'm kind of wondering if maybe it's just, for me, 30 hours a week is kind of the magic number. Maybe anything more than that, I burn out, I get stressed, I stop having fun. And also not having my financial stability dependent on StarCraft takes off so much pressure. The other thing I was kind of thinking is, at work, like, there's been things where, like, oh, I've got a, you know, kind of a project I'm starting to work on. And I'm still really new there, so they don't yet give me any of the really intense stuff. But still, once upon a time, it would be the kind of thing where, like, the performance anxiety would kick in, you know? It'd be like, oh, what if I drop the ball here, you know? But StarCraft has kind of done away with that. Like, anything that would have previously made me nervous, it just doesn't really compare to playing StarCraft. I have no idea why StarCraft has this intensity level that nothing else can match. But the performance anxiety from playing against a really good player in StarCraft with a bunch of people watching is just on a whole different level from anything else. I have no idea what causes that, but either way, I think it's kind of a cool kind of thing to keep in mind. Got a bit of a supply block here that gets corrected pretty quick. Kind of a cool thing to keep in mind, because that also means that if you're the type of person like me who can get nervous and choke, then you might as well kind of confront that. And if StarCraft's a way to do that, then that may improve your performance in other aspects of your life. You know, anything else that makes you nervous is going to be a little easier to deal with because you're constantly being, you know, confronted with this performance anxiety in StarCraft land. So, kind of a bizarre thing to think about. It just kind of crossed my mind when I was at work the other day. I was like, wow, this doesn't bother me at all. And in a large way, that's because of going to MLG and things like that. So, pretty cool. Alright, so we've got Si Yong. I'm going to go and slow us down here. This is a really long game, so I pushed it out quite a while for the two-speed, but not a lot to talk about early game ZVP in the first place, and this game is ridiculously long, so I didn't want to drag it on too badly. Si Yong going for a going for an immortal expand pretty good here. Now, I scout a robo, but I do not scout one really important thing. He's got blink on the way. Now take a look at this. This is so great. This is the first time I've ever been confronted with this. He's got an observer spotting where my locusts are coming from. He's barely seeing my swarm hosts, and I really, at this point, should have queens already up so that I can snipe that over that observer. But check this out. Right after the locust spawn, he blinks in. He's going to trade maybe one stalker, but he's getting now two swarm hosts. Three, just about. There we go. four swarm hosts. I mean, he can trade all these stalkers away at this point, and it was cost effective. That was such a good way to establish tempo in the game. I mean, those four swarm hosts mean the difference between me taking out this third with ease and now me on the defensive for easily the next 10 minutes of gameplay. I can't stress enough how cool that was. That was just exactly what players need to do, Protoss players. So any Protoss players watching, pass this along. Anyone who's having trouble with swarm host play and they like Blink Stalker openings, this is where you're at. I would say the two viable ways to deal with swarm host right now that I've seen, here we go again, another really good one. I sniped that observer so that at least he's having to focus my queens rather than my swarm host. But anyways, the two big kind of viable openings that I'm seeing are going to be quick Blink Stalkers or quick Colossus, and I'm talking like two base double robo. That seems like it's not viable, but versus swarm host, it's a must. So I get a decent trade here. Let's check losses. I'm actually still behind on unit resources lost. He's just trading so cost effectively, and all the while he's building up some sentries, some immortals. He's finally getting into Colossus. Looks like he might even be on double. Nope, he's on single robo. He just had two move out at the same time. Bit of a wasted chrono boost there, but that's fine. He's playing just so phenomenally here. It's not really going to make a difference. I'm on the three base. Let's see where economy is. He's ahead on economy as well. And that's, I expect to be behind on economy. I just don't expect to be down, what, 10 swarm hosts by this point? I mean, this should be enough swarm hosts, had I not traded them all away, to completely clean up this army. But instead, I'm you know, losing another swarm host there, and I'm barely getting ahead on losses for that engagement. So, I mean, he's just picking his battles perfectly so far. I can't say it enough just how good he played this game. See Young moving up now. He's cleaning up my creep. This is great. He's going to go ahead and put me on the defensive here for quite a while, since that creep spread is really necessary to be comfortable pushing those swarm hosts forward. And every time I have pushed forward, he's punished it with ease. Blink back. Pretty good micro here. You know, kind of could have been perfected a little more just by blinking one stalker back rather than all of them so that some other stalkers take some shield damage. And at this point, I'm just hoping I can go ahead and get him diverted from my third, because really, with the losses I've taken, I can't afford to lose my third. Normally, in a swarm host game, I can lose my third all day long because they're taking such heavy losses in the process, but this is not a normal game. I just haven't established that momentum that I usually get. Alright, so at this point, I'm kind of realizing that I can't wait for that mass of 20 to 24 swarm hosts. I've just taken too heavy of losses, and he's kind of got my number here. So I'm switching into roaches. Normally you would see Hydra, but the reason I go into roaches here is just because I'm not really concerned about an air transition, and aside from that, I need mobility. And so I would rather have roaches here because I need something that's going to be able to buffer the stalkers, and on creep the roaches are still a little faster. So that means I'd rather have roaches in this case, especially since he's already made his Colossus transition. Getting a little bit of a good catch here. Still great Blink Micro on his part. I think I do get a couple units here. Yep, one Stalker. Almost. There's two Stalkers. And then some damage. He's getting another Blink forward, but this isn't going to really pay off. Already ahead of him this time. And I'm going to have to start getting better at reading when my opponent is going to be aggressive with these Blinks, because it's going to completely change the dynamic of when you pull up your swarm hosts, when you move forward versus backward, that kind of thing. You're not going to be able to just read the Colossi moving into your locus and move back. Instead, they're going to, you know, like he's been doing, he's going to separate his stalkers from the Colossus Sentry Zealot Ball, and he'll pull back with the main army, which will bait me to move forward with my swarm hosts, and then his stalkers get some free cleanup. And so this is going to change that entire read. So I think that's really cool that this, at a higher level of play, is going to become such an interesting matchup. I really think that this is going to make some really good spectator, some really good games for spectators moving forward, especially once we get to see the Koreans put this to work. Unfortunately, they've still been fairly reluctant to implement the new units. Alright, so we've got Seon taking the mid. I've got a slight supply advantage because I went into heavy roaches here to try and recover a little bit and get some buffer. But with this gold, he's going to be able to trade now and not really be too terribly concerned. I'm starting to get that swarm host efficiency kicking in. Now I'm almost at double his unit efficiency for losses. So that's good, but I'd rather it be more around 4-1 at this stage of the game rather than just 1.5-1. Alright, now I accidentally made a Infestor there. This is going to be pretty embarrassing here in a moment. Get ready for it, get ready for it. I move forward, get that fungal. Oh, come on, where's that fungal? Where's that fungal? Oh, now he's bouncing around. Now he's getting stuck behind Locus. And, oh, yeah, look at that fungal. Beautiful. So, yeah, let it be known. I'm horrible with Infestors. Alright, so we got a little bit of a blink in here. Good move from Seong. Got a couple spines up, but it's not going to be enough. It's just buying me a little bit of time. So the Locust buying some time up front. I'm hoping I can go ahead and get my Queen Hydra Roach back here to clean up these stalkers, so that at least I can make sure that in terms of army losses, he didn't trade cost effectively, because two spines, a Hydra thus far that I've lost, he's going to lose most of this army. So that's a good trade, actually, since he didn't take out any tech, but this up here kind of nullifies that a little bit. Getting a little bit of lag. Hopefully it's not producing too much video lag. Trading away too many drones here. I thought I could get more damage done than I did. I kind of just underestimated what plus 3 attack can do as far as quickly cleaning up your Locust. Not used to being 3 attack versus 1-1. Usually it's 3 attack versus 2-2, and that actually changes things quite a bit. But what I had to do is I actually had to delay my 2-2 at a point there. There was actually a point I should have probably pointed it out, because there was a decision here that actually saved me in the early, when he was pushing my third, saved me from losing that third so soon. I actually did end up losing it, but I actually had to cancel my 2-2 to go ahead and max out my supply and have enough to push him back. Alright, cleaning up more creep again. Seong still playing really, really well. Staying aggressive, making sure he keeps that third, or that gold from taking any pressure. Getting a good snipe here on the Hydra Den, also going to get my Roach Worm. But I'm finally getting some Vipers out, and that's going to put me at a bit of an advantage against this Colossus. Now the big issue is we've got this huge Stalker Ball, but that's where Transfuse can really start going to town. I absolutely love Transfuse. If you've got the APM and the multitasking for it, you can really do well with Transfuse. I was hoping to cut him off here. I do finally actually get a break here, because he does a bit of a move command there, trying to catch my Swarmos, and it was not cost effective at all. We've got now losses that still looking not where I'd like them to be, but at least I'm trying to start pulling ahead. Getting my, let's see, what do I have actually? Where's my tech? Oh, I do not reproduce my Hydra or Roach Den. Ooh, that's not good. Roach War. So at this point, I'm just getting my Swarmos count back up a bit. And he's back to his warp in shenanigans. He's got charge as well, so that's going to make things that much more difficult to work with. A clutch transfuse there on that queen. At this point, I'm really worried about efficiency. More and more of that becomes an important thing here. Could have actually gotten another transfuse there now that a couple more queens arrived. Up front, we've got Locust pushing, and I had a little Roach Hydra kind of split my army up there so that the Roaches and Hydras could do a little bit of free damage with the Locust buffer. So that was a good trade on my side there, continuing to push that advantage a little bit and make up for the fact that he's got gold and 30 extra harvesters on me. But at this point, I mean, these Vipers in particular, they've got to really be the star of the show. I'm going to need them to do so much damage here moving forward, especially with clearing out his Colossus count, so that those Stalkers can't just blink forward every time they want to. I'm letting that Observer go, and that's actually really bad on me. I've actually been losing some Overseers here throughout the game. And so, I actually in this case have some, but they just weren't at the right time in the right place when my Hydras and Queens passed over. So I got to be more kind of conscious of that, actively looking for them. Getting some good damage here. I could have probably just directly targeted that that Nexus and already had it taken out, but instead cleaned up a couple cannons and a lot of probes. I think in this case, given that this is a gold, it would have been better off just to go ahead and take out the Nexus outright, especially since he already used that, that Photon Overcharge? No. I can't remember what it's called. So, another warp in here. This main is pretty much all but dead. And really, at this point, it's not even worth the investment to try and get any more spores and spines up to defend it. I really just need to keep my army size high. Look at that. 93 health. It is officially going to be dead very soon. But the problem with losing your hive now, it used to be, and I actually, this didn't click for me until this game, actually. Once upon a time, losing your hive as a Zerg player was no big deal as long as you've still got your Greater Spire and Ultra Den tucked away somewhere. But now, losing your hive means no more Vipers. You don't have a tech building dependent on that. Here we go. Great blinding cloud there, but he's also getting some really good storms. So huge trade on both sides. He's forced to blink forward, forced to commit, and this is exactly what he should have done. If he pulled back out of the blinding cloud, I just get all sorts of free damage. But instead, he cleaned up a ton of my swarm hosts. Let's see what my swarm host count is now. Yeah, I'm down to 16 swarm hosts. I was at about 24 before that engagement. So this actually is favorable for me, but because of that blink forward and those great storms, it wasn't as good as it could have been. Giving away some Vipers here, Miss Micro on my part. I was hoping to get up there. There's a grab. But yeah, had he just pulled back, it would have been probably 4 to 8 Stalkers for free, and probably a Colossus with where I had still some energy on my Vipers. But instead, he forces a trade and gets my Swarm House count down a little bit. And I'm really getting sloppy here with the Vipers. I gotta admit, this game had me a bit frazzled. I was just not used to playing against someone who's so aggressive with his Stalkers. So I was kind of thrown off balance, admittedly. You know, we're seeing a lot of kind of little subtle miss micros on my part, and that's just because I'm starting to hit these players who are throwing management at me, unit management at me, that I'm just not used to facing. I'm used to seeing some cute blink micro to make sure the locust damage is minimized, but this kind of aggression, never. On that note, forgot to mention a really cool thing, actually. The MLG stream actually had one of my games. Actually, a game I played against Grandmaster player Batman. Apparently, he submitted the replay asking how to beat Swarm Host. And I can't remember what it's called. Rules of Engagement, I want to say, with Axe Lab. Went ahead and did the cast of it. So that was really cool. And it was a game that I won, so that was kind of fun to see. Getting some good damage there with that Roach Flank. Got those High Templar cleaned up. That was really critical, because this is a stage in the game where I can't afford... Like, let's check that income. Yeah. I can't afford to be taking all sorts of free losses to High Templar. I can't make Vipers any longer, so feedback's not a concern, but Storm still is a huge problem, especially with so many low-health Swarm Hosts. Alright, so he's getting a little aggressive here. Now, I'm actually thinking what I should have done here is actually manually split up these. What I did was I right-clicked the pathing there to just go ahead and try and put it in the middle so that they split up. But think if I had just boxed these and put them down there, boxed these and put them up there, so that he's got locusts on either side of him, then I can collapse in on him and hit a pincer. That would have cleaned up tons of stalkers. But instead, I only had like 3 swarm hosts worth of locusts in back and everything else in front. And so the natural choice was just for him to retreat and take maybe 1 or 2 stalkers worth of losses. That could have ended the game right there, honestly, had I managed those swarm hosts better. You know, I'm continuing to work on that. Actually, I had a bunch of games that I played on Thursday, I believe it was, where I actually just exclusively used multi-pronged swarm host play. Split up my swarm host, tried to... There we go. That splits a little better. I didn't manually set it up, but that's exactly the kind of thing I was going for before. But I'm trying to kind of conceptualize games where I maybe go up to 30 swarm hosts, but instead of 1 pack of 30 swarm hosts, I have 2 packs of 15 that I'm managing independently. Now, the multitasking required for that is pretty intense, but if I can get it towards something I'm comfortable with, I think that'll take this to a whole different level. Alright, so he's doing this run-by business again, and this is going to work out really well. I'm getting a ton of damage here on his gold, but you know, he's getting a ton of damage on my swarm host, which is really where it needs to be. Now, I get that snipe on that over on that observer, which is really, that's your stopgap measure. If they only have 1 observer, then just snipe that observer. They're going to be forced to trade with your Hydra Queen Roach, which is what you want, while taking tons of free damage from those locusts. But more and more Protoss players are going to be sending in 2, 3, 4 observers to spot those swarm hosts, because every time they commit to that, it needs to pay off in damage to your swarm host count, not damage to your regular army. Miss Micro here, no good. I hate that the burrow radius on a swarm host is actually larger than the unit itself. That's what causes that Miss Micro. You probably see that a lot for me. And that's something you've got to be kind of conscious of, is once you get up to 14 to 16 swarm hosts, you're going to start seeing that if you rally the locusts too quickly, they won't, 1 or 2 of them won't have time to burrow, and so you'll give the existing unburrowed swarm hosts a move command while the locusts are being given an attack command. Getting a ton of free kills on those probes. I love this gold here in Antigua Shipyard for that purpose. You're going to be able to clean up so many probes from the high ground with Hydras. And at this point, the mining there almost becomes a liability because they're mining less than the value of the probes, as long as you continue trading with those probes every time a locust spawn occurs. I'm still sitting on 40 drones, but I've got nothing to mine with them. So at this point, I really should already be trying to sneak some distance mining here with the gold, or setting up a third somewhere tucked away where he can't attack it without forcing a base trade. Alright, so this spawn, I actually spot that he's going for this, but I spot a little too late. What I should have probably had is a reposition on my locust, and I walk into that storm. I actually kind of hesitate there a bit and shuffle inside of the storm, really bad on my part. But he blinks up, and maybe that was a little too aggressive here, because now he's going to be taking some losses where he can't afford to. He's now officially down to zero mineral income, because he keeps having to pull back from that gold, and I got that that fifth taken care of over on the corner. Now, I was intending to drop creep, but currently I have no lair. So technically he can walk right up, and that's kind of an interesting thing. If you lose your lair, they'll keep dropping creep. You just can't issue a new command. But yeah, technically he can put a nexus under those overlords, and I can't do a thing about it because I don't have lair tech currently. If I recall, I do start layer tech here. I actually remember regretting it, because we're now at a stage of the game where every bit of minerals counts, and layer tech is probably not as valuable as an extra couple roaches or an extra couple hydras right now. So, really kind of down to the wire game here. I love this, and I'm hoping I'll see more and more of these now that I'm hitting Grandmasters regularly. Wasted locust spawn there. Should have had that managed where I was going over cleaning up that nexus. But at this point, he's just barely mining minerals on those eight harvesters. And he actually, if anything, should be pulling these off gas, because he's got plenty of gas. He can continue to make high Templar and get that spend. Huge storms there. I get these drones out, so that is good at least. Should have had those locusts already spawning up top. Now, these drones, what I did was I boxed the locusts, and in the process, I accidentally boxed the drones as well. So they were intending to move down here, and instead, I actually sacrificed a ton of drones. I was at 40 drones just a second ago, down to only 16 now. And in a situation like this, I would love to have 40 drones on one patch of minerals, since they're all going to be distance mining anyways. You can't afford a hatchery in this situation. So here's that splitting up of my swarm host. I start to recognize that his army count is not where it needs to be any longer to be able to really deal with multi-pronged swarm host play. So I split him up here, going ahead and cleaning up that nexus so that I can at least make sure that he's not out mining me any longer. He's down to only 25 supplies, so things are definitely in my favor, but this is really interesting. Check this out. He's got a mothership core, and what do I have for anti-air? Nothing. So he has one observer, one mothership core, and I've got 19 swarm hosts. So what do we got? We got a spore crawler all the way. We got two spore crawlers. I should have grabbed that one too. But yeah, here in a moment we're going to see me grab that spore crawler, because that is officially my anti-air for this game. So really kind of cool play on his part. He recognizes he's got a lot of gas sitting around, and that he cleaned up all my anti-air in the previous engagement via his Colossus and High Templar. And we're down to the wire here, so I can afford one Hydra. There's my one Hydra. Great cleanup here on these drones. Every drone really counts here. Those are worth their weight in gold right now. So at this point, I'm getting a little sloppy here with those swarm hosts, just trying to make sure that I can get something done here. But at the same time, I didn't have a locust spawn coming up, so that was bad. Pull back that Hydra a little late, and that was another really important thing. But I did get his mothership core cleaned up there, combination of the spore crawler and the Hydra. So at least that got taken care of. I also got his observer, I believe. Nope, there it is. All right, and on his side, we've got, let's see, six drones now distance mining. And I've got nine drones distance mining when I'm able, but Colossi clean up drones so fast that I'm having to be real cautious with them. Splitting up my locusts again. I need to be careful how I do this, especially when he's still got an observer in play and I can't shoot it down. You know, I can't afford to be trading away swarm hosts too heavily. Now, he doesn't have a lot of army left, but, you know, if he gets me down to eight swarm hosts, I'm probably out of luck this game. But here we go, getting some probe kills. This is great. If I can get all these probes, then that's going to probably be game. But I let them move. Come here. Ah! Yeah, I let them get aggressive on the Colossi. If I would have done a hold position there, I would have killed the remainder of his Probes. And he probably would have GG'd out right then and there. But right now, as long as he has even just a couple Probes mining, he's still in this game. Especially if he can get another Mothership Core out. Alright, so I'm pushing him up top. We see here, what I'm doing here is, since I recognize he's having to push way up there, these Swarm Hosts may get some more free damage on the Probes. So I'm going ahead and sending them down, seeing if I can camp out at that gold, while these Locusts hopefully cut off his ability to block that. But he gets in on the high ground too soon, and oh god, losing more free Swarm Hosts. I didn't see that he got up on the high ground. I thought he was still camping out up here, maybe coming along the side. So I was hoping I could get up on that Zelnaga Tower, because that's really what's keeping him in this game, is keeping control of that center. He can see where the Locusts are coming from. He can make sure he holds back his Probes if necessary. He can also make sure he's dodging them with his Colossus and three Stalkers. So, really cool end of this game. I love that this plays out like this. I mean, we don't get to see this kind of StarCraft much anymore in Wings of Liberty. It's just usually so one-sided in one direction or the other. New Mothership core coming out. Great way to spend his minerals. I mean, that's just what's going to keep him in this game before I can't afford to make any more anti-air. If I had an infestation pit, actually I think I do, this would have been a great time to get some infestors out. That would have been a good way to get that gas spent and also get some on-the-fly anti-air when I need it. Gets a little too aggressive there. And all the while, he's going ahead and getting some free shots here on my Swarm Host, so I'm pulling back. But it's going to take forever for this Mothership Core to do much. No upgrades on the air. Almost get that Observer. And he GG's out. What I missed there, actually, was that Swarm Host spawn. He didn't quite move away far enough, and I got the Colossus. And three Stalkers aren't going to be able to do much against 12 Swarm Hosts. I can just continue splitting them up and denying mining while I continue to distance my gold. So, yeah. cool game. I had a lot of fun with it. So, I'm going to try and make the next one of my ZVTs that I've had recently that went into late game and had a lot of fun Swarm Host play. But I really had to cast this one. This was just such a unique game. Alright, so everyone watching in YouTube land, thanks a bunch for watching, and be sure to subscribe.